time of the cyclone in 1990, Samoan blown away. And those people, they move inland. Cyclone Val, blown another one. Finnish tsunami and the cyclone 2012. They need to move, but it's expensive for them. And some people say, oh, this is my land from my great, great, my ancestors who want to stay there. But in this time, now they said, we move.
The old village of Sanapu is right on the coast. The coast is retreating. It's being eroded little by little, essentially because of sea level rise, but also because of big events. So the village is basically pushed away from the coast, but they belong to the coast. So there's a really strong problem there. We need to move, but we don't want to move.
My boss told me, oh, they need to help your village. And so, okay, I'm come and join. And, but when I hear about what they wanted, oh, that's very good for my village. So that's why I'm here. I need to talk with them and have a plan.
He knows everything that happened in the village. Every house is the history of the houses, what happened through the 1990 cyclone and what happened for the 2009 earthquakes and tsunamis. So he tells us that. And then we scientists take those information and we put that in our GIS and computer and then we work at it. But he's got this information at his hand. So we're really trying to stretch the oral information, oral traditions, and merging with our Western science approach, and it's been working quite well so far.
I'm very happy when I'm here with this group, going to help my village. Maybe we build a good emergency shelter. They're going to help my village and the south side of the island, not only my people,
yes, lots
my
of
village
people,
people but lots of people.